Monoclonal antibodies are an emerging technology being used for a variety of different conditions. In the past, these have been used for autoimmune disorders and for treatment of different cancers. For example, HER2-positive breast cancer uses the drug Herceptin that can bind to the overexpressed HER2 receptor and then neutralize this receptor from working, thus not allowing the breast cancer to grow or spread as much. But these antibodies can also be used for different pathogens. One way they can be used is to bind directly to the pathogen and slow it down. They can also serve as a beacon to then recruit a white blood cell to come and destroy that pathogen. Next, they could also be used to bind to different toxins secreted by the pathogen that would otherwise cause harm to our cells, but have now been neutralized. And third, they can be used to inhibit different cell signaling pathways that the pathogen needs in order to grow and replicate, such as from moving to point A to point B. But these monoclonal antibodies are also now being used for treatment of COVID-19. And two companies have FDA emergency use approval, one of them being Eli Lilly, where these antibodies now bind to the spike protein of SARS-CoV-2 and not allowing it to infect our cells as much. Regeneron also has monoclonal antibodies that bind to our ACE2 receptor on our human cells, not allowing SARS-CoV-2 to infect our cells as much. And both of these antibodies have had great promise in clinical trials for patients with mild to moderate COVID-19 and who have other health conditions and who have not gone on to experience severe COVID-19 related illnesses. However, these monoclonal antibodies are not being suggested for anybody who already has severe COVID-19 or who is reliant on a ventilator. But these monoclonal antibodies are showing great promise for the treatment of COVID-19, reducing our severe symptoms and reducing the casualties associated with this virus.